Hello everyone, welcome to my channel which is Learning Institute, and today I am going to discuss about some numerical problems on nuclear basic properties. So let's start the question. So first question is, the stable nucleus that has 1 by 3 the radius of osmium nucleus is what? Lithium, oxygen, helium or nitrogen? So as we know that the relation between radius of nucleus and atomic radius is given by r proportional to a to the power 1 by 3. Now let the radius of oscillation is ROH and radius of unknown nucleus is Rx. Now given that stable nucleus has 1 by 3 radius of osmium nucleus, so we can write as Rx equal to 1 by 3 times ROS. Now from equation 1, ROS is directly proportional to 189 to the power a by 1 by 3 because oscillation's mass number is 189, and the formula is R proportional to mass number a to the power 1 by 3. So this is equal to k 189 power 1 by 3, where k is a proportionality constant. Similarly, we can write for Rx proportional to Ax power 1 by 3. Let Ax is the atomic mass of unknown nucleus. So this nucleus ke bare mein hame janna hai, usko hum Ax maan rahe. Ab isme se kaun sa nucleus hoga, wo hame batana hai. Now from equation 3 and 4, from this and this, we can write as k Ax power 1 by 3 equal to 1 by 3 k 189 power 1 by 3. After solving we get this. Then cube, taking cube on the both side, we get 27 Ax equal to 189. So Ax equal to 189 upon 27 equal to 7. This is mass number 7 is the atomic mass of a stable nucleus, which is 7. So the element is lithium. So this is the right answer, lithium. So the correct option is A. Now the next question is, the binding energy of a hydrogen atom. Hydrogen atom means electron bound to proton is 13.6 electron volt, and the binding energy of positronium, electron bound to positron, is what? So first option is 13.6 upon 2 electron volt. Second is 13.6 upon 1810 electron volt, and this is third and fourth. So to solve this question, first of all we consider the hydrogen atom. So we know that the for hydrogen atom the binding energy is 13.6 electron volt and it has only one electron. So for positronium the binding energy will be half of the hydrogen because it has one electron and one anti-electron. Clear? Positron ki binding energy half hogi hydrogen atom ki, kyunki hydrogen atom contain karta hai ek electron aur ek anti-electron ko. So the binding energy of positron is half of 13.6 electron volt. That is the option A. Clear? Now the next question is, the binding energy of K cell electron in a uranium atom. it is z equal to 92 and a equal to 38 will be modified due to screening caused by other electron, and second, the finite extent of nucleus as follows. So the first option is increases due to first, and the remain unchanged to second. So these are the four options. So we know that in case of screening caused by other electron, the binding energy of K cell will decrease. Also the finite extent of nucleus will decrease the binding energy. So the option B is correct. So this is the theoretical question which is asked in 2013 GEST. Now next question is, a hydrogen atom in its ground state is collides with an electron of kinetic energy 13.377 electron volt. The maximum factor by which the radius of the atom would increase is. तो क्वेश्चन है कि कोई हाइड्रोजन एटम है ग्राउंड स्टेट में कोलाइड करता है किसी इलेक्ट्रॉन से जिसकी एनर्जी इतनी है, तो मैक्सिमम कितना फैक्टर होगा जिससे उस एटम का रेडियस इंक्रीज कर जाएगा, हाइड्रोजन एटम का इंक्रीज कर जाएगा. सो वी नो दैट द एनर्जी फॉर द nth सेल nth स्टेट फॉर हाइड्रोजन इज En इक्वल टू -13.6 अपॉन एन स्क्वायर इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट. So for ground state energy, that is n equal to 1, so it is equal to -13.6. Therefore the difference in energy -13.6 minus of -13.37 electron volt, and this is equal to -0.223 electron volt. Now let us check which state is this. So since -13.6 equal to minus n square is equal to this much, so this is equal to this. So after solving this we get the n square equal to 61. Therefore the radius Rn equal to n square a naught. So this is n square times a naught. So we can say that the radius will increase around 61 times. So the option D is correct. So the correct option is D. Clear? Now the next question is, given that the ionization energies of hydrogen 1H and lithium 3Li are 13.6 electron volt and 5.39 electron volt respectively, and the effective nuclear charge experienced by valence electron of lithium atom may be estimated in terms of proton as 0.63 electron, 1.26 electron, 1.59 electron, or 3.00 e. So as we know that also given 1H1 is equal to ionization energy for hydrogen 13.6 electron volt, and for lithium 5.39 electron volt, and we know that the electronic configuration of lithium is 1s2 2s1. So given ionization energy value is for n equal to 2, we know that the expression for energy En equal to Z F effective square upon N square into E1, where En is the energy of nth level, Z effective is the effective nuclear charge, and E1 is the energy of first orbit of hydrogen atom. So after solving relation, Z effective equal to N under root En upon E1, given that E1 equal to this and En equal to minus 5.39 electron volt and n equal to 2. Putting this value in relation, Z effective equal to 2, this is 2, 5.39 upon 13.6, and this is equal 1.26. Thus the effective nuclear charge expressed by the valence electron of lithium atom is 1.26 electron times E, simply 1.26 times E. So the correct option is B. Clear? So this is all about today. In the next video, we give some other questions. So thanks for watching video. Thank you.